Hi there, you're watching India This Morning with me, Viren Khrao, here on Mirror Now. Let's begin with a look at the headlines before we take you to other news this hour. In yet another case of hospital apathy, alleged delay in ambulance services claims a life in Karnataka. Family also claims lack of proper treatment. No licenses, illegal contracts, poor labourers locked to hide irregularities. The startling reality emerges in the probe over the Bhavana fire that claimed 17 lives. Ramesh Kovani, the owner of Mumbai's Kamala Mills, has been arrested by the Mumbai police for complicity in the fire 24 days after the fire that killed 14.
देखिए माउंट एडा का कोई विषय नहीं है सुप्रीम कोर्ट का ऑर्डर जो होता है वो हमारे लिए मान्य होता है तो सुप्रीम का जो ऑर्डर है उस नाते से अगर कोई अपील के ऊपर न चलाना चाहेगा तो बहुत अच्छा होगा अगर कोई चलाने की इच्छा करेगा तो उसको सिक्योरिटी दी जाएगी इसलिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट के ऑर्डर को मानना ये हमारा दायित्व है
Violent protests in Ujjain, Jaipur, Kurukshetra and Mumbai. Cars stopped, highways blocked and buns planned. The fringe gets a free run as states abdicate their responsibility. Let's begin with some news just breaking into us now. After an Andhra Pradesh state transport bus driver lost control of his vehicle on the 14th of January, CCTV footage has emerged of the incident which left four people injured. The incident took place in West Godavari in Andhra Pradesh where the bus ended up smashing into a bike showroom where all of the four men were in fact standing. Let's go across now to my colleague Paul Hooman who's joining us on the phone line this morning. Good morning, Paul. We're seeing first CCTV footage of the incident in which these four individuals, in fact, sustained injuries.
Well, wherein this particular incident happened on the 14th of January, and it was a week later that the cops have actually accessed the CCTV footage and made it public to the media. In fact, this incident happened in a village called Chintalapudi, located in West Godavari district of Andhra Pradesh. The speeding APSRTC bus, which is an AP Andhra Pradesh State Road Transport Corporation bus was moving towards Eluru village and it belonged to the Eluru depot. It was speeding is what we're hearing. Suddenly the driver lost control of the car, of the bus, I beg your pardon. And you can see how the bus rams into this Bajaj showroom, which is a two-wheeler showroom. Five people who least expected this to happen were sitting around a table and they were discussing something related to work we're hearing. That is when the bus rammed straight into the showroom and all four of them were injured. You can see how one of the men was stuck between the table and the bus, and it was after the bus actually took a reverse that he could move out of that particular fixed location. However, those locals rushed to the spot and took them to the hospital. Out of four of them, three of them were grievously injured, we heard. But however, a week later now, all of them have recovered. A case has been registered against the driver and they're probing as to what exactly. Was it a brake failure? Was it over-speeding or just negligence on the part of the driver that led to this accident?
Well, absolutely. The visuals there, of course, first CCTV visuals of the entire incident, which in fact saw the bus ramming into the bike showroom where these unsuspecting men were standing and just going about their daily routine. Thanks, Paul, for joining us. Now, moving next to the storm and the fury over Sanjay Leela Bhansali's Padmavat, the Supreme Court will today hear the state government's pleas to ban the release of the film in their respective states. The governments of BJP-ruled Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh moved the top court on Monday, appealing against the top court's decision to lift the ban, in fact, that they had imposed on the movie Padmavat.
Talking about the protest of Karmi Sena, Mumbai is bearing the brunt of it. If we talk about the how it started in Mumbai, on Sunday night they blocked these protesters of different groups. They blocked the Mumbai Ahmedabad highway and they burned tires on Ghodbandar Road. In fact, last night also they blocked Mumbai Pune highway and they burned tires at Washi, Panvel, Thane, all these areas. Some arrests were done. These people were detained for a while. In fact, not arrested, they were detained for a while. But as of now, we are yet to see some concrete steps being taken by the state government of Maharashtra and Maharashtra police and Mumbai police for that matter.
Now, meanwhile, with protests in Ujjain, Jaipur, Kurukshetra and Mumbai, the fringe groups have intensified their efforts against the film that they claim memes history. Yesterday, a mall in Gurugram was vandalized by masked Karni Sena workers, the CCTV footage of which is now on your screens. Now, at the helm of the opposition to the film continues to be the Rajput Karni Sena. From announcing a bounty on Bhansali's head to threatening to cut off the actress Deepika Padukone's nose, the Karni Sena continues to threaten multiplex owners and has vowed to disrupt rail services now in Maharashtra tomorrow.
हम जनता कर्फ्यू पर थे सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज सुप्रीम नो डाउट इन दैट पर हम जनता की अदालत में हैं जो इस डेमोक्रेटिक सेटअप में सबसे बड़ी अदालत है जनता कर्फ्यू जनता के द्वारा जनता के लिए फिल्म हॉल वालों को तय करने के लिए अब हम छोड़ रहे हैं राम के साथ या रावण के साथ
आप समझते हैं कि जनता विरोध करेगी तो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट जो है वो रोक लगाएंगी इसके ऊपर लॉ एंड ऑर्डर के चलते
देखिए स्टेट गवर्नमेंट नहीं लगा सकती अब तो सिर्फ केंद्र सरकार सिनेमेटोग्राफी एक्ट के सेक्शन 6 के तहत या सेंसर बोर्ड रिवोक कर सकता है या सुप्रीम कोर्ट वापस अपना फैसला जल्लीकट्टू की तरह वापस लेगा ऐसा हमारा
रिव्यू पिटीशन से आपकी क्या उम्मीद है
सर एक मानता हूं कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट सुनेगा इसी के लिए तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने आया ट्वीट कर लिए नहीं तो दो दो राज्य सरकार और कल 11 राज्य सरकारें और जारी है 11 दो 13 राज्य सरकारें अगर ये कहेंगी कि कानून व्यवस्था के तहत बहुत बड़ा खतरा है आप वापस से सोचिए सोचेगा सुप्रीम कोर्ट ताकि आवाज इस तरह से थोड़ी दबा सकते
आमेर के दरवाजे बंद किए जाएंगे जयगढ़ के दरवाजे बंद किए जाएंगे नारगढ़ के दरवाजे बंद किए जाएंगे जब तक फिल्म बैन नहीं होती और पूरे देश में जितने भी मोनूमेंट है राजस्थान में ज्यादातर राज परिवारों से हमारी बात हुई है और उन्होंने हमें आश्वासन दिया है कि हम आपके पक्ष में ये जो भी मोनूमेंट है हम उनको पर्यटकों के लिए बंद कर देंगे और मेरी आपसे अनुरोध है ये केंद्र सरकार से फिल्म को बैन किया जाए नहीं तो हम हमारे उन ऐतिहासिक स्मारकों को किसी भी पर्यटक के लिए खोलने नहीं देंगे
Let's talk about the Bhavana fire now. Negligence. That's the reason that 17 laborers with their escape routes were charred to death in an illegal firecrackers factory in Delhi's Bhavana. As agencies submit reports, skeletons continue to tumble out of the closet. Mirror Now has learned that the building did not have any alternate escape exit. That the staircase in the building was so narrow, which made it impossible for anyone in the building to escape the fire. And that the factory had no permission to manufacture firecrackers. The raw material for which caused the blaze. Further, we've also learned that the factory lacked a no objection certificate from the fire department and worse still, the licensing authority MCD had not even referred the building to the fire department for inspection.
Yesterday we saw how the Delhi Infrastructure and Industries Development Corporation had come out with a report and said that at the time of allotment of this particular factory that burned down and killing 17 people and injuring many others did not have the required permissions given to it by the municipal corporation, that is the trade licenses and the building bylaws requisite permissions. However, according to the Factories Act as well, there were no inspections done of this entire area where this factory was located, and looking at that fact, there are multiple agencies involved in giving licenses to factories. First of all, Bhavana being an industrial area, second of all, the municipal corporation being responsible for its inspections, as well as the labor department where under the Factories Act is also responsible for carrying out inspections in these areas. However, 15 days ago is what we know when this factory started operating, and that too the permission was taken for plastic pellets, and inside there what was happening was repackaging of firecrackers.
Meanwhile, the founder chairman of the Labour Welfare Committee has said that the factory did not have the required permissions and that this is the case for majority of such factories all across the city.
Complete violation of labour laws hai mein aur ye इतना बड़ा हादसा आज तक दिल्ली में इस ढंग से नहीं हुआ पहले भी एक सिस्टम है बेसिकली ए मैकेनिज्म टू इम्प्लीमेंट द लेबर लॉज इज़ विद द लेबर डिपार्टमेंट एंड लेबर डिपार्टमेंट इज़ डायरेक्टली विद द Delhi government. I'm not leveling any, you know, fictitious charge of against any government or any organization. Basically, it is the duty of the Delhi government to implement labor laws, or especially the law under the Factory Act. Factory Act provides the safety of the worker. Okay, what type of safety the owner of the industry should provide to the workers. In this case, there was a total disregard of the laws, and I don't think ever even a single inspector of the labor department have visited this industry ever, whether this industry is working as per the norms and the labor laws. They have never visited. 90% industry जो आज दिल्ली में चल रही हैं, किसी में भी सेफ्टी का नॉर्म मैं 100% कहना नहीं चाहता हूं, लेकिन 90% में कह सकता हूं किसी इंडस्ट्री में सेफ्टी का कोई नॉर्म, और कभी भी इससे बड़े हादसे हो सकते हैं। ये मुझे इस बात का डर है कि केजरीवाल राजनीति ना करें और इसमें जो मजदूरों की जो सेफ्टी है, कल्याण के काम है, उनकी तरफ जाए और 1-1 करोड़ रुपया इन मजदूरों के परिवार को दे, तब हमको सांत्वना मिलेगी इसमें।
Well, it was Bhavana in Delhi and then it was Kamala Mills in Mumbai. Now we talk about the commercial greed and negligence which took place in Mumbai 24 days after a deadly fire that engulfed two swanky restaurants at the Kamala Mills. The owner Ramesh Govani has now been arrested for complicity in the negligence that led to 14 deaths in the two rooftop restaurants that were found to lack necessary permits and proper fire escape routes. So far, the Kamala Mills director Ravi Bhandari, Yug Tully and Yug Pathak, co-owners of Mojo Bistro, where the fire supposedly started, and three owners of the one above pub, Kripesh Sanghvi, Jigar Sanghvi and Abhijit Mankar, where most of the 14 deaths took place, have also been arrested. Two fire officials and two managers of one above, Kevin Bava, have also been arrested.
This is the 12th such arrest that has been made since the 29th of December fire that engulfed and 14 people lost their lives in that. And so far we are getting that after the mere four days after the BMC's probe report came out and it was submitted to the Chief Minister, and taking a cue from that, the police have investigated and then done their own investigation and booked this is the second owner of Kamala Mill who has been booked for culpable homicide not amounting to murder for section 304. And as it was categorically written in the BMC probe report that all the owners of Kamala Mill's compound, as well as the architect, as well as the interior decorators, are equally responsible for giving out the space and flouting the rules and regulations that are needed specific to the fire department and fire safety of a space, specifically a restaurant. And after that, the police went ahead, did their investigation, and this is the second owner who has now been arrested. And today he will be presented in front of the Boyiwada court along with the five other people who have also applied for bail today. So clearly multiple developments are slated to happen as we progress in the day.
Now, a family in Bengaluru is alleging hospital negligence after 32-year-old Rudrappa's death. Now, Rudrappa was rushed to a hospital in Chamarajnagar district after he consumed a vial of poison, which later claimed his life. The family of the deceased has claimed the hospital showed laxity, while the delay of the ambulance driver and the lack of proper treatment resulted in his death. The family has also accused the hospital of making the patient wait for over an hour before treatment was finally started. The hospital superintendent has initiated an inquiry and has promised action if anyone is found guilty. Let's go across now to Imran, who's joining us on the phone line. Imran, the family alleging here that this man was denied treatment for over an hour. Give us some details about exactly what took place.
Well, this incident is coming from Mysore district in Karnataka, wherein this person allegedly committed, he consumed poison. And what we know from the family, when they informed the hospital authorities, the ambulance driver came and the ambulance driver demanded money before he could be shifted to the hospital. It went on for some negotiation. The family was like, because of the situation, they paid an amount, and when he was rushed to the hospital, the duty doctor didn't attend the patient for almost more than an hour. This is what the family alleges, due to which the death of the patient happened. Now, the family protested in front of the hospital along with other family members. And after the, only after that, the superintendent of the hospital came and assured them that action will be initiated against the ambulance driver and the duty doctor. They shifted the body from the hospital. As far as we know, as of right now, an inquiry has been initiated. The health minister has also asked for a report about this incident. And they say that any person responsible, action will be initiated against them.
Well, absolutely, Imran. We'll continue to track the story as it develops. Now, with just days left for the Union Budget 2018-19, the urban infrastructure is one of the primary concerns of the citizens of the national capital. While traffic jams have become a part and parcel of everyday commute of the citizens in the capital, the promised metro lines are in desperate need of a boost to try and ease the common man's woes.
The metro has emerged the preferred choice for the common man in the capital. While phase 3 of the service is preparing to be operational in the next 6 months, the phase 4 has run into some political rough weather.
The only separate mention in the last year's budget was about 150 crore rupees that was granted to the Delhi Metro for extension of NCR areas like Noida, Ghaziabad, Bahadurgarh. While Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated the Magenta Line, which is the first driverless metro, on December 25th, the fate of the Delhi Metro Phase 4 project continues to hang in balance. With approvals pending before the centre and the Delhi government, the Delhi Metro Phase 4 project has been delayed over the past 1 year.
Phase 4, which is facing a 2022 deadline, has proposed lines spanning around 104 kilometers that provides connectivity to the city's outskirts, the airport and South Delhi. It is expected to carry 8.5 lakh passengers every day. It comprises a 67 kilometers elevated corridor, adding 79 stations to the network, out of which 50 will be elevated. But the political will could be the biggest hurdle facing it.
No doubt that it is going to be delayed. The main problems are manifold, in fact. First thing is the will of the court, both at the center and the state. That will is missing. That is first thing. In today's world, money is not a problem at all. So it is unfortunate that we are not able to implement the next phase. It should be implemented immediately. And certainly it will go a long way in decongesting and comfortably people.
For 2017-18, the centre had allocated 64,900 crore rupees to the Ministry of Surface Transport to decongest our cities. The ministry is now seeking an additional 25,000 crore rupees. Ring roads are also in the pipeline, aside from the country's first driverless pod taxi system on a 70 kilometre stretch from Dholakuan in Delhi to Manesar in Haryana. The citizens of the capital are waiting for a concrete plan to ease their traffic woes.
हमेशा जो है सो जाने आने में ऑफिस पकड़ने में तो हमेशा दिक्कत होती है
अगर इसको हम थोड़ा रोड चौड़ी करें या ट्रैफिक को सिग्नल व्यवस्था और अच्छी कर सकते हैं तो ज्यादा अच्छा हो सकता है हम लोगों को परेशानी कम हो सकती है
सबसे बड़ी दिक्कत यहां पे यह है कि रोड इंक्रोचमेंट काफी है यहां पे तो गवर्नमेंट को चाहिए कि जो भी इंक्रोचमेंट है उसको हटाना चाहिए
अभी हमें ऐसा है कि 15-20 मिनट का सफर 1-1.5 घंटे में कवर करना पड़ता है तो गवर्नमेंट जो कर रही है अभी बहुत स्लो कर रही है जहां तक मुझे दिख रहा है
With massive traffic jams becoming a daily reality in every Indian city, the Ministry of Highways and Road Transport has sought for an additional 25,000 crore rupees as budgetary support in the upcoming fiscal to address the problems through infrastructural upgrades. But integration with various public transport and optimum utilization of existing infrastructure is vital to cater to the Delhi's growing urban needs. In New Delhi, this is Apurva Sridhar for Mirror Now.
Well, with that, it's a wrap on this edition of India This Morning on Mirror Now. But stay with us as we bring you the latest from across the country.